Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. Today we are going to be taking a look at the 9P149. Now I know that I am a few hours late to this and I knew last night I would be a few hours late to this and the Victory Day announcements. That's because I was up quite late and went to sleep only a couple hours before they ended up posting them on the website. So I apologize about that. But we are going to take a look at the new, I believe, Soviet, honestly kind of neat looking, anti-tank guided missile carrier. Again, the 9P149. What a great name. Oh, it's so good. So this is the MTLB, is the well-known multi-purpose armored personnel carrier that was fitted with a huge variation of armament, including the... Okay, now I'm not exactly sure how to get the pronunciation down on this missile type. Google Translate told me it's Shturm or Shturm. I'm not exactly sure how accurate that is, so we're just going to refer to it as the S-missile, because that's what it is known as up here on the development blog, at least, just so I don't continue to piss anyone off by mispronouncing something in the video. So, missile system, which was capable of destroying heavily armored targets. Here's some history on it. And let's go ahead and take a look at the basic information. So the 9P149 is the vehicle that's coming. It is an anti-tank missile carrier, and it will be for the nation, USSR, or Russia, and will be a rank 6 vehicle, which is to be expected. The pros of the vehicle are that it has access to two different types of ATGMs, it has a very low profile, so it's rather flat, and it swims, so it is capable of traveling across water. Therefore, it is an amphibious vehicle, which is... also very curious, because I'd like to see more of the different variety types of vehicles in the game. And now we've got another one. The cons, however, are that it has very poor defense and is easy prey from the air. So it doesn't have much armor defense. It doesn't seem to have any machine guns or, you know, it doesn't have any like main cannons or anything. The only thing it's got is its ATGM. At least I don't think it's got any machine guns. I would doubt it, considering it's a... I could be wrong, but... oh, wait, actually, no. Was that just the missile? I think that was just the deployed missile. Yeah, it is. For some reason, I thought that that was a machine gun there, for some reason. But no, that's just the thing that the missile's attached to. And if you look in the video, you can see it actually pops off once you fire the missile. There you go, look at that. That's pretty awesome. I like that. Okay. Briefly, the 9P149 will make the perfect vehicle for hunting down enemy armor. Fantastic mobility, low profile, and 12 guided missiles in stock. In War Thunder, the 9P149S, if you will join the ranks of the Soviet rocket systems as a lethal and stealthy hunter of the enemy heavy armor. Its lightweight enables the vehicle to be highly mobile and travel at a speed of 60 kilometers an hour when moving forward and 10 kilometers an hour when going in reverse. Why would... I mean, it used to be the joke that the British didn't have the reverse speed, but what fucking Russian tank these days has a reverse speed that is of any importance up here, even at high ranks? Oh man, it's like the Russians didn't know how to go backwards. Moreover, its low profile and lack of any kind of superstructures, not counting the launch system, allows the 9P149 to stay stealthy even in relatively flat terrain. The vehicle is only fitted with protection against bullets. Even its most armored spots have a thickness of only 14 millimeters, and the reason for that is because the 9P149 was never intended to be deployed at the front lines. Oh, I see. Okay. And, I mean, look at the fucking... You're going to be able to... hide behind small hills and debris and debris and stuff, and just fire your missile over top of that without anybody being able to actually hit you. Depending, because this thing has kind of a length to it, so I don't know how that's going to play. You're going to have to find a very specific type of cover to hide behind. The S ATGM is capable of reaching enemy units as far as 5 kilometers away. When are you ever going to need that? And its missiles have a penetration capacity of 560 millimeters. And if it will not be enough, it also has the ATGM, I don't exactly know how to pronounce that either, ATGM, which can penetrate 800 millimeters of armor, which would suffice for practically any target on the battlefield. And this combat vehicle carries as many as 12 of these deadly missiles. In the case it's impossible to get close enough to your enemy on land, the MTLB can travel on water at a speed of up to 6 kilometers an hour, and even shoot from short stops while floating. Fun fact, throughout its 50 years in service, over 80 different kinds of submodels of the MT-LB were created, ranging from APCs to weapon systems, some of which are still in use to this day. Well, it's a nice-looking vehicle. I actually kind of like how it looks. Well, there you've got one of the missiles. I'm not sure which missile that is, but it's one of them. There you can see a side shot of the vehicle with its bicolor winter paint, which is also not that bad looking. An ass shot. It does not look comfortable to be sitting in one of these things. And another shot. I just like how flat it looks. The 9P149S is a rather frail yet lethal combat vehicle, especially if you are proficient at ambush tactics and aren't too lazy to change your position quite often. I feel like they're taking shots. Our Soviet ATGM carrier will appear in War Thunder Update 1.89 very soon, and we are just as excited about its appearance in the game as you are. So yeah, there you go, guys. That is an upcoming Rank 6 ATGM carrier for the Soviet Union. If you haven't been following along with the development blog, Update 1.89 will bring along with it the Imperial Japanese Navy tech tree, which will include things like the Kyoshimo, which is a current pre-order Rank 3 premium destroyer, the PG-02, which is a pre-order Rank 2 boat for the Japanese tech tree, the number 4 type CH-8, which is a Rank 2 subchaser for the Japanese, and of course the Rank 4 Kuma class light cruiser for the Japanese, also coming to the tech tree. And if you also missed it, they announced the Bradley AD-ATS, which is a new top-tier Rank 6 anti-aircraft vehicle for the United States. So, yay. Now, we're going to go ahead in the next video and take a look at the Victory Day announcements and the various specials they're doing for that. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next War Thunder upcoming content video.